ओके फाइन, मॉर्निंग, सो आई एम ऑडिबल, सो बोल्ड इज विजिबल यार। इज इट ऑडिबल?
यस सर।
यस सर।
फाइन, सो आई थिंक इन यस्टरडेज क्लास वी वेंट थ्रू विद अ लेफ्ट हैंड साइड सीक्वेंस ऑफ जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म एज वेल एज बोथ साइड सीक्वेंस of your Z transform, and we got to know how the ROC exists. So if it is right hand side sequence, your ROC lies outside circle. So the condition is Z greater than A. So if it is left hand, it is going to lie inside a circle because Z is going to be less than A. Similarly, both sided means it's a combination of right hand and left hand. So you got to know that how a concentric ring is obtained, where exactly your ROC lies in the last class. So I think we solved few problems on that. So now we'll move on to next main topic, properties of ROC. So they may ask you to list the properties of ROC. Totally there are 9 properties. A small proof is there for each. You just need to make a statement. That's all. Okay. So proof, a small proof, and you have to list all the 9 properties. So you can expect for 9 marks. They may give you list the properties of ROC. Okay, put on the heading as properties of ROC. So you hope everyone know what is the meaning of region of convergence, right? So let's move on with properties now. So as I said, 9 property, we will go one by one. Put on first one, list the first one. The ROC for a finite duration, ROC, property number 1, ROC for a finite duration, finite duration sequence, ROC for finite duration sequence includes entire Z plane, includes entire Z plane except Z is equal to 0. Z is equal to 0, you can write the thing like this, and or, so any one or both can be possible, Z is equal to infinity. So I hope you already proved the condition right. So ROC exists for entire Z plane except two sequence Z is equal to 0 and infinity. This is for your finite duration sequence. So statement is written, property number 1 statement. Everyone, shall I move on?
Yes, sir.
Good. Read on the proof now. So proof for this statement. Proof. A small proof is there. So you need to list all the properties properly with one example. Okay. Read on the proof. Consider a finite duration sequence. Consider a finite duration sequence, x of n equals, so x of n is given for you as 1, 2, 1, 2, and origin is at 1. 1, 2, 1, 2, and origin is at 1. So let's try to find a Z transform for this given x of n sequence. So what is a given sequence, guys? X of n is given. So what is X of Z formula? Can anyone tell me what is the transform formula? Yeah.
Sigma n tends to infinity.
Summation of
minus infinity to infinity.
Minus
infinity.
X of n.
Z. Now tell me what is the summation now? N is going to vary from where to where, guys?
Minus 2 to 1, sir.
Minus 2 to 1. Origin is there, that is 0. So behind that will be minus 1, minus 2. And next to 0, there is 1 value. So it means it is going to vary from minus 2 to plus 1. Agree? Agree, everyone? Am I clear till here? Shall I proceed?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, go ahead. So now what you want to do, you just need to expand this. dump the value in that and get the answer. So if we expand this, so it is like substituting n is equal to minus 2 first. So x of minus 2, z raised to, so minus of minus become plus, so it is become z square, correct? Plus x of minus 1, z power 1, okay? Then x plus x of 0, z raised to 0, plus x of 1, z raised to minus 1. So this is what the things what we have. Is it visible what I'm writing downside here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now concluded. So what is x of minus 2 answer? X of minus 2 is 1. So 1 into z square, it is going to be x of minus 2 value is there, right? 1. Correct, na? So this is going to be z square plus what is x of minus 1? It's 2. So you can write z. Plus x of 0 is 1, so z raised to 0 is also 1, so it is going to be what? Plus 1. Plus x of 1 is 2, so it is going to be 2 z inverse, again it has 2 by z. So this is my x of z answer for a given finite duration sequence. Am I clear? Okay,
yes,
na? So then what we have to prove? This property, right? So if we give z is equal to 0 in this, if we give z is equal to 0 in this, so what is x of z, guys? Is it infinity?
Infinity, sir.
Yes, sir.
Correct, huh? Similarly, if we give z is equal to infinity, then also it is infinity?
Yes, sir.
So you can make a statement after this. Here, x of z is going to become infinity. Here, right on? Here x of z is equal to infinity for z is equal to 0 and z is equal to infinity. See, why are given and or r means some cases you may get only this or only this. Or some cases like this you can get both. That's why I've written and slash or. That is the meaning of that. Okay. So hence the property 1 is proved. Understood? Understood how to solve properties of ROC, the first one. Am I clear? Is it fine, guys? Shall we move on to the next one? Second property?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So just conclude that. So just conclude that here x of z is going to become infinity for z is equal to 0 and infinity. This proves the above property. So that is the end of first property. Fine. So let's move on to second property. Let's move on to second property. Read on. ROC does not contain any poles. ROC does not contain any poles. So there is no picture of poles in the ROC. I hope you remember in control system we had a concept of poles and zeros. Correct? Huh? So your denominator represents poles, numerator represents zeros. So in ROC, there is no concept of poles. That is property number 2. Read on. ROC does not contain any poles. So read on proof. So we'll take small example. Proof. The Z transform of A power N into U of N. The Z transform for A power N into U of N is calculated as. I hope you remember the formula what you got for this A power N into U of N. What is the formula, guys? X of Z. You have proved this right. A power N into U of N.
1 minus A into the power minus 1.
So what was the condition for ROC? The condition was your Z is greater than A. Correct, na? So if you take Z inverse as 1 by Z, and if you apply a logic of your LCM, so just check out, can I write this equation in this form? Can I?
Yes, sir.
So you just mentioned this, I just taken this Z inverse as 1 by Z, LCM, and this Z present which was denominator, it goes to numerator. Okay. So after this, Radon, is it fine till here? Shall I proceed? Is it okay? Shall I proceed, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, after this, Radon, here, or in this function has pole. Underline the word what I'm telling. In this function, or this function has a pole, at z is equal to a. So existence of pole is there at z is equals to a. But what is the condition says? It says always z should be greater than zero. I mean greater than a. So it means the existence of pole doesn't come to picture. I'll repeat. If you write z by z minus a, at z is equal to a, pole is there. But the condition says it is greater than a. So it means what? You just add a sentence after that. So note that the ROC exists for z greater than a. This means poles does not lie on ROC. This means poles does not lie on ROC. So is it proved? Property number two. Any doubts here? Is it okay till here? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So property number one is done. Property, see, try to remember the heading properly because it is going to be asked for list. Okay. Proof is just a small proof like how we are doing now. Okay. So let's move on to property number three. Property number three, Radon. ROC is the ring. Property number three, your ROC is a ring. So I hope you remember this, right? ROC is a ring in Z plane, centered above the origin. I'll repeat. ROC is a ring in Z plane, centered above origin. What is the meaning? So you remember this. This is origin, right? So you have a ROC like this. So it is in the ring form, correct? And it is above your origin. So it is above to the origin. So that is what the meaning of property number three. Is it fine? Heading is written.
Yes, sir.
Good. So now, in order to prove this, just a statement you are supposed to write, guys. So proof comes for the sequence what you have solved already. That is a power n into u of n minus 1 minus a power n minus n minus 1. Correct? So I hope you remember that left hand right hand sequence, right? So you just remember, consider a power n into u of n. So if you apply a z transform for this, you got answer 1 divided by 1 minus a z raised to minus 1 under the condition z greater than a. Correct? Z greater than a. Similarly, one more we add and one more function. What was that? Minus a power n u of minus n minus 1. If you apply z transform, here also you got same answer, but the variation was less than a. Less than a. Written till here. Shall I proceed?
Yes, sir.
So now tell me, is it matching with your answer? Say, oh, you remember. What is the ring formation you got for this a power n u of n? So it was like this. ROC was outside. Similarly for this, ROC was inside. But where was the circle? It was lying exactly on above the origin. Is it how it was looking in both the condition? Yes or no, yeah?
Yes, sir.
So is it clear? So this is what the statement you have made. So from this consideration of these two examples, you can write on below this, here after the student here, observe that z. So whenever I say z, it's magnitude, because always you have to take positive values. So z is always a circular region. Z is always a circular region or a ring formation, correct? So always z is in circular region or a ring form, centered above the origin. That's it. That is property number 3. I hope you have understood the first 3 properties. Am I clear till here?
Yes, sir.
Good. So let's move on to property number 4. See, just try to remember the headings, guys. If you remember, this you can add as a proof and you can make a statement. What was the heading you have written? That you have to be proved, that's all. So nothing proof or derivation much. Just a statement wise, you need to conclude it. Go with 4th one. So property number 4. So property number 4 is mainly concentrated on right hand side sequence. Property number 5, left hand side. Property number 6, both side. So this you already learned. You just make a statement, that's it. So property number 4. ROC of causal sequence, ROC of causal, or you can write a general sequence, ROC of a general sequence, in the bracket you can write right hand side sequence. So right hand side sequence is of the form R. So what is written here? Instead of writing A, that is with respect to R. I hope you remember, right? So we wrote a unit circle. So there, if A was given, then I have chosen the radius as 1. Means A is equals to 1. So nothing but radius only. So instead of that, we can write it as general A. So you know that R is equal to A. That's why we replaced there the radius as R. So the condition is ROC for a right hand sequence, Z is greater than R. Statement is written. Everyone, statement over here.
Yes.
Okay, write on that proof. Just a statement you have to write for the proof. This you already done, right? Same thing you have to write in a statement. Proof. Consider the right-handed sequence. Consider right-handed sequence A power N into U of N. So consider the right-handed sequence A power N into U of N. Its ROC is this condition. Correct? So Z greater than A. Its ROC is this condition. Therefore, ROC of right-handed sequence. Therefore, ROC of right-handed side sequence is of the form Z greater than R. Is of the form Z greater than R, where R represents what, guys? R represents the radius of a circle. R represents the radius of a circle. So I hope you have seen this in the diagram, right? So this is the radius what we discussed. Am I clear with property number 4, everyone? So same way you can replica property number 5 and 6 for me. So ROC for left hand side sequence, you just make this as less than R. So it means a sequence is going to be minus A power N U of minus N minus 1. So under this less than condition, it is going to match. Is it okay with property number 4? Shall we move on? Everyone? Is it okay, guys? Yeah. So go with the same way. Property number, I will make alteration itself. So this is going to be property number 5. So property number 5 says ROC of left-handed sided sequence. ROC of left-handed side sequence is of the form Z less than R. That is the only change. Correct? So proof, same thing. Consider a left-hand side sequence minus a power n u of minus n minus 1. So this is a left-hand side sequence. Its ROC is less than a. Correct? Its ROC is less than a. Therefore, ROC of left-hand sequence is inside the circle of radius r. So this is what the ROC picture for your left-hand sequence. Correct? ROC is inside with radius r. Is it okay? Property number 5, everyone. Am I clear?
Sir, repeat that last sentence once again, sir.
Yeah, I'll repeat. So, what was the condition we are proving? We are proving ROC for left-hand side sequence. Okay. So, consider the left-hand side sequence minus a power n into u of minus n minus 1. Okay. In which ROC exists for the condition z less than a. Is it done till there? Shall I continue now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, therefore, ROC of left-handed side sequence, is inside a circle, with radius r, So this is how it looks, inside a circle with radius r. Am I clear? Is it okay, Ananya?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So after knowing 4 and 5, I hope you can write 6 by your own, right? So 6 is nothing but combination of both, both set sequence. Write on that. Property number 6. See, remembering the properties will be easier for you. Because what all the derivations you have done earlier, same thing we are listing and making it as a rules. Property number 6. So what is the condition? ROC for both side sequence, right? ROC of both side or two side sequence, both are same. ROC of two sided sequence is a, how it is? Both side sequence, is it a? How ROC looks in both side sequence, guys? It was a concentric ring, correct, na? So how
yes,
it was looking? It was looking like this. So it was a concentric ring. So you can consider the ROC in this form, correct? So this is what the meaning of two sided sequence. Put on the statement once and I'll repeat. ROC of two sided sequence is a concentric ring in Z plane. So this is a Z plane in which it is like a concentric ring. Proof. We know that ROC of both side sequence is given as a power n u of n plus b power n u of minus n minus 1. Is it sure? A power n u of n belongs to left-hand side sequence. Left-hand side sequence is a power n u of minus n minus 1. So what was the condition, guys? So under this condition, what is the condition? Z is between a to b. Cut up. So in this example, 0 to a and outside 0 to b. So this is how we have learned yesterday. Return till you.
Yes, sir.
So after this, just concluded. Hence, it is a concentric ring. Hence, you can conclude the things. Hence, it is a concentric ring from the above condition. So this completes property number 6. So Any doubts, anyone from 1 to 6 property? So remaining 3 just statement. Is it okay till here? Shall I proceed? Yeah, guys, is it okay? Shall we proceed?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, go with property number 7 now. Property number 7. Read on. If x of n is a finite, if x of n is a finite causal sequence or a general sequence, if x of n is a finite general sequence, then its ROC is, then its ROC is entire z-plane. If x of n is a finite causal or a general sequence, then its ROC is entire z-plane except z is equal to 0. Except z is equal to 0. Okay. So we'll try to understand this in a proof. Put on the proof. Consider a causal sequence or a general sequence. Consider a causal or a general sequence. X of n is equals to 1, 2, 3. So this is a given sequence, guys. Then its Z transform will be. So can you tell me what is the Z transform for this? What is x of z? So if origin is not mentioned, what is the default origin, guys? It goes to
1, sir.
Good.
One.
So it goes to 1. So straight away, can we write the equation x of 0, 1, 2? So summation will varies from 0 to
0.
2. So x of 0 value is how much? 1, z raised to 0. Kata. Plus, I'm writing that answer. I hope you can understand, right? So x of 1 value is 2. So z raise to minus 2. Plus 3, z raise to minus 3. So from this you can conclude 1 plus 2 by z square plus 1, 3 divided by z cube.
Is it okay?
I think it's square, no?
So z bar 1 and z bar 2.
Yeah. So this is minus 1, minus 2. Okay, va?
Yes, sir.
So if you look at this sequence, only at z is equal to 0, it is not going to converge us in a z-plane. Apart from that, can you expect for all the values? Am I clear what I told? If you put 0 here, it's going to become what?
Infinity.
So if the statement what you made for 7th property is except 0, z is equal to 0, ROC exists for entire z plane. So for that, you can write one example like this and you can conclude. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Good. So go with property number 8. See, 8 and 9, just a definition, guys. So just make a note of property number 8. Read on. ROC of a stable LTA system. ROC of a stable LTA system contains unit circle. ROC of a stable LTA system contains unit circle in the z-plane. Unit circle in the z-plane. I hope at the beginning you have done right. So we have wrote a circle with radius of 1. That is called unit circle. Is it fine? Property number 8. So ROC of a stable LTA system contains unit circle in the z-plane. Is it okay? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
So last one, property number 9. This is also a statement. Property number 9. ROC is a connected region. ROC is a connected region. See, whenever we plot any ROC, that indicates what? that is having a connection with respect to your Z plane. So ROC is a connected region. It means what? So the convergence happens with respect to some particular area. If I say right hand side sequence, the ROC lies outside circle. So it means convergence happens outside circle. Area is there outside. If I say left hand sequence, it is going to be inside. So the area is going to be inside. If I say both side sequence, it's in the form of concentric ring. So the area is present inside the concentric ring. Am I clear the meaning of property number 9? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
So you just add a sentence for this as a proof. So what I told, we will just make it as a statement. So the heading was, the ROC is a connected region. Proof. The convergence of the sequence exists over, convergence of a sequence exists over a certain area rather than discrete points. Hence, ROC is a connected region. Am I clear to everyone? Is it okay, guys? So any doubts, anyone with the 9 properties what we listed? That completes the properties of ROC. See, if you list the 9 properties individually, you can expect 9 marks. So just a listing of properties will give you 9 marks. So am I clear till here? Any doubts, anyone with the properties of ROC? Is it fine till here, guys?
Yes, sir.
Good. So let's move on to the next topic, that is properties of Z transform. So if you finish these properties of Z transform and problems on that, that finishes almost 25 marks for the exam. Clear? So take heading as properties of Z transform. So totally you have 13 properties. So which you already learned, nothing new. You just need to analyze the thing with respect to Z transform, like linearity, time shifting, time scaling, multiplication. I hope you remember this, right? In the first module, everyone, the same concept repeats. Only thing is, I need to apply the concept of Z transform because this is a discrete concept. Okay, put on the first one. So we'll go one by one now. So first property, linearity. Linearity. So I hope everyone knows what is the meaning of linear, right? What is the meaning of linear? Linear means what?
Straight line.
Okay, with respect to straight line, okay, I can tell linear means it's something get kept constant. So whatever the variations happens with respect to my input, same thing you can expect at the output. That is what you learned in LTI properties. Do you remember?
Yes, sir.
So same way we'll implement the things using your Z transform. So concept is simple. So if you have x1 of n with you, if you apply a Z transform, it is going to become x1 of z. Kata. So if you have x1 of n as your input signal, if you apply a Z transform, it is going to become x1 of z. Similarly, if you take x2 of n, if you apply Z transform, it is going to be x2 of z. Now, if you do combination of x1 and x2, so what could be the output, guys? That is also same, right? x1 of z plus x2 of z. am I clear till here to everyone? Is it okay?
Yes,
so now you got the difference, right? If you take individually how it looks, if you take together how it looks. Now if I make some variation with respect to my input by adding some coefficients called as A1 and A2. So what is the change you can expect in the output level? Is it same? Is it same? So if you have
yes.
variations with respect to my input, same thing you can expect at the output also. So this is what the meaning of linearity. So this is what you're supposed to prove using your Z transform concept. So this is your statement. So this is let concept what I wrote. So you need to prove this by applying your Z transform concept. So we'll move on with that. Is it fine till here? Shall I proceed with the proof?
Yes, sir.
Good.
Yes, sir.
So go with the proof, guys. So I hope everyone remember the base formula, right? So we just try to write the base formula of your Z transform. Try to analyze a condition and write. So we just need to write a linearity property condition. So what was the condition? X of n. So the x of z is equal to plus infinity x of n z rest to minus n. Now tell me, what is your x of n? Yeah, Dikshit, anything you want to tell here? Dikshit?
No, sir.
Okay. So x of n is what we have chosen, guys. We have chosen as a1 x of n plus a2 x2 of n. Just substitute that here. So this we are trying to prove this condition. So this is given as a1 x1 of n plus a2 x2 of n. So this complete term is going to be multiplied with z raised to minus n. Correct now? So now z raised to minus n is applicable for this a1 x1 also, a2 x2 also. Similarly, the summation is applicable for both the sub inputs x1 x2. Agree?
Yes, sir.
So now how we can write this, guys? After multiplying z power n and splitting the summation, how it looks? So just check out, is it how it looks? A1 x1 of n z raised to minus n is one term plus a2 x2 of n z raised to minus n is one term. So from this, what is a1 and a2? Is it a constant terms? Can I throw it out?
Yes, sir.
So if you just take it out, it is going to be a1 summation of, so just represent the remaining terms as it is. So here a2 will comes out. A simple proof. If you understand the logic, if you remember the formula, nothing else. So now tell me, what is this equals to? Is it like your Z transform?
Yes, sir.
So if it was x of n, I should write x of z. Since it is x1 of n, I can write x1 of z. Therefore, we can write a1 x1 of z plus a2 x2 of z. Is it what the proof you wanted, guys? Is it what the proof you wanted?
Yes, sir.
The meaning of linearity, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Clear till here? So if they ask you to see, whenever they ask you to prove the property, they may give you 3 to 4 properties in one question for 12 to 12 marks. So you can expect 3 marks if it is 4 questions like linearity, time shifting, multiplication, causality like that. Okay. So try to analyze the thing. Yes, it's simple. Formula, if you remember, substituting the things and getting the answer. So am I clear till here? So you need to remember this property properly, because in the problems, they won't mention that for this particular problem, you need to apply this property. By seeing the question, you need to debug. So I need to apply shifting. I need to apply linearity. I need to apply multiplication. In that way, you have to analyze. So is it fine? Shall I move on to the next one? Second property. Yeah, so move on to second property.
Yes, sir.
Time shifting or transition. So time shifting, I hope you already learned shifting concept, right? Same thing we'll implement now. Put on property number two. Time shifting property or translation. So translation means converting or moving the things. So I hope you remember time shifting property in module number one. So we had a concept of advance and delay. Do you remember?
Yes, sir.
So same thing we'll try to analyze here. Hold on, the condition, if x of n is an input, if you apply z transform, you are going to get x of z. Okay, wow. If I apply a delay with respect to my input, so n minus 1, then what is your z transform output is a question. So the condition is z power minus k into x of z. So this is the formula you need to remember this. Whenever you are shifting with respect to my input, you can expect z of minus k, x of z condition. So we'll try to prove this. So got a statement for time shifting. Shall we move on for the proof? So what is x of z now? So x of z formula, summation x of n into z raised to minus n. Got now? So here what I am changing? I am changing my n to n minus k. Correct now? So if I change my n to n minus k, then you need to prove x of z transform for n minus k. Correct now? So this is going to be remaining same. Only change is x of n become n minus k z raised to minus n. Is it okay till here? Is it okay, guys, till here? Shall we proceed?
Yes.
Yeah. So if you look at this condition, see, there is no formula for x of n minus k using our z transform. So if you do some manipulation, instead of this n minus k, if you have only one variable, for example, if you take n minus k as some m, then x of m into z power of something, that we can implement in the formula. So that is what the logic you need to analyze. If you have x of n minus k, there is no formula. You need to make it as x of some m form. So now what is the assumption we'll make? We'll try to make some m as n minus k. So if you take n minus k is equal to m, fine. So what is going to become n, guys, from this? Because you have n in that formula, right? So what I can write instead of n? Is it k plus m or m plus k? Both are fine?
Yes, sir.
So I can write it as k plus m. So I'm going to replace this n with what? K plus m. So now tell me, if you vary something here, obviously the summation also gets changed. Correct, na? Yes or no? Now tell me, if I make m is equal to infinity and minus infinity, what is the variations will happen here? So you just, wait till where you wrote here? Is it done till here? So after this, you just make a sentence. So let us consider n minus k is equal to m. That is one condition. Hence, n is equal to k plus m. Similarly, you need to make a condition that m is varying from minus infinity to plus infinity. So these are two assumptions you need to make. So n is equal to k plus m because of upper condition, and m is equal to minus infinity plus infinity. After substituting this in the above equation, how it looks? I'll just keep this much. Yeah. Substitute this in above equation. Tell me how it looks. So summation m varies from minus infinity plus infinity. So what was x of n minus k? Now it is going to become x of n z power minus n is there. So what shall I replace with n, guys? Now n was, you got just now, as k plus m. So you can write as k plus m. So is it okay till here? Is it okay till here?
Yes, sir.
So now what you want to do, you can split this z power concept to two, right? So summation m varies from minus infinity plus infinity x of m. This I can split as what? Z power minus k into z power minus m. Agree? Because minus is common there, I put it inside. So now from this, which is an odd thing or a constant thing? Which is odd or constant from this equation?
So z power minus k is constant.
Good. So z power minus k is odd. It means you can throw that out. So if you take it out, how it looks? Z power minus k summation m varies from minus m plus infinity x of m into z power minus m. So now tell me how this is. Is it like x of z? Is it like x of z?
Yes, sir.
So therefore, you can conclude. So the z transform for your x of n minus k is equals to, so z power minus k is kept as it is. So this complete term I get as x of z. So this is what the proof for your time shifting or translation property. Am I clear?
Yeah.
Clear,
yes,
yeah. So we'll stop here. So take a quick 10 minutes break. So anyhow, it's continuous class. So we'll meet you back. Okay. You can enter attendance and you can leave.